Boom. So now, I'm like, all right, so I knocked that out. Boom. She get high. Whoa, whoa, whoa. So now I started, I was like, you know what? You playing with me? I'm going to show you what it is. But I was being petty, but I was having fun. You feel me? It's turned into some other shit. It stopped. Said something about me again. And then after that, you know, old girl jumped in it. And so I got on her. Family really fucked up. I shouldn't even really be talking about their family like that. But she started talking about my son and all kind of. That's the only reason why I kept it going. Bitch started talking about my son. I'm like, and then other like, yeah, you're not supposed to say nothing. I'm like, bitch.
Don't nobody need reality TV when we out here living life. That was OT Genesis clapping back to Keisha Cole's sister. We'll discuss that. We also got some COVID-19 news where you can get toilet paper and a sad story involving landlords. And then to end on a fun note, we've got some Marvel news we're going to discuss and somebody getting a little talk with Marvel that the fans have been wanting to see. If you're finding me for the first time, please subscribe to this channel. Turn on the notifications. A lot of people said they haven't been seeing my videos because their notifications got turned off. Turn them back on. Follow me on Instagram. And if you really like what I do, we've also got a podcast. In the very beginning, you saw an Instagram clip of the R&B / rapper singer OT Genesis. What's been going on with him? He's had a back and forth with Keisha Cole that stemmed from him using one of her more popular songs that led up to this weekend. She liked something 21 Savage liked, and then he came out and said, her, you know what, smells like fish. And so Keisha Cole's sister, you know, gonna defend the family, decided to clap back at OT Genesis for basically defaming her sister, or should I say the cash cow for the family. And OT Genesis didn't like what the sister said, so he took to Instagram to drop that message. A lot of people are feeling like, as a man, you shouldn't go at a woman. I don't necessarily believe in that. If someone is attacking you wrongfully for whatever the reason, I don't see a problem with you going after her verbally if she's attacking you. But in this situation, it seems as though OT Genesis is probably on the back end of this quote-unquote attack. He goes on to further say, so a bitch can talk about my son, but because she's a woman, I can't say nothing. He said, I love every woman in the world, just not that bitch. Damn. If y'all were following the drama on Instagram page, things got heated between OT and Neff, and OT even threw shots at Keisha Cole's mother, who had struggled with addiction, and Neff threw shots about, get this, y'all, saying that old boy got damaged sperm. Damn. Since the Instagram Live, neither Neff or any member of her family has responded to his little story time. And OT posted that he's finally just going to leave the situation alone. Folks, I think it's a good thing for both of them, because I don't know where this ends. What do you have to gain by going back and forth over an about a two-year-old issue? Just leave it alone. You keep making your music. You keep letting Keisha Cole's sister do what she do with Keisha Cole. And just let bygones be bygones, man. Move on. OT Genesis just got him a movie role. I say just move on, bruh. Keep doing what you do. Let it all be. In COVID-19 news, ladies and gentlemen, I've got some good news and I got some bad news. I guess I'll give you the good news first because that's the easiest. People have been raiding stores of toilet paper like they got bullet wounds in their butthole. Like they're trying to shove toilet paper to stop bleeding in the butthole. So people have been struggling trying to find toilet paper. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you can get toilet paper from guess where? The dollar store. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I've gone to 3 or 4 different dollar stores in my area of Greensboro. And they fully stock with toilet paper, but they limit you to 4. It's only a 4-pack of toilet paper anyway, and they limit you to 4 packs. But if you're struggling, if your booty is thirsty, and you need something to wipe it, you're getting low on the rolls, Go to the dollar store. The dollar store has toilet paper to fulfill those requests. And in sad COVID-19 news, ladies and gentlemen, check this out, what landlords have been doing. And you guys can chime in on how you feel about this. On April 1st, it was reported that only 69% of rents were paid. Immigration attorney Kevin Block said he's very concerned about the reported incidents of landlords propositioning their female tenants for sex. He's upset about that because if you have a certain amount reported, there's probably more unreported. Just like with COVID-19, if they say 10% of the population has it, it's more like 35 to 40% probably really has it. And this is going on with landlords, ladies and gentlemen. You know, basically they're telling these women who may not have all the payment or can't pay, you scratch my back or you scratch somewhere below the belt, I'll scratch your back. Now, I know some of y'all are saying this happens everywhere with women. Some women exchange that favor for getting speeding tickets reduced or canceled altogether, or some people exchange that favor in the professional realm. As a person who owns real estate and has tenants, I'm of the mindset you never mix business with pleasure. But furthermore, we're having a crisis right now, and it's not right for you to be making women do this who really don't want to do it. Now, for those of you that have some understood agreement, y'all talked about this, I'm not going to say it's wrong. However, is that considered prostitution? And prostitution is only legal in one place in the United States and not everywhere else. If you really want this to go on, maybe you should petition your state legislature to make prostitution legal. But to make someone do this and they don't want to do it, and you know their back is up against the wall, they might have multiple kids, they can barely feed their families, it's just totally wrong for you to do that. You should not be making someone do something like that against their will when you know they're desperate. I personally don't believe in mixing business with pleasure. You will never, ever see me tell a tenant I want to exchange any favor. Maybe they are a trainer of some sort. I'm not going to be doing any bartering because you don't mix business with pleasure. It messes up your bottom line. It can ruin you and your quest to be financially free. And plus, it's wrong. That ain't in nobody's tenant landlord agreement. Stick to the agreement. If this is going on, it needs to be investigated and it needs to be stopped if these people aren't accepting these terms. And I don't know anywhere where that term has been put into anybody's contract. And in a bit of fun Marvel news, ladies and gentlemen.
Finally, there's this four-paneler, which I have to appreciate as it'll be the closest I ever get to playing a comic book hero.
There has been a lot of fanfare around John Krasinski and his wife, Emily Blunt, joining the MCU, potentially doing the Fantastic Four, with Krasinski being Mr. Fantastic, Emily Blunt, his real wife, playing Mr. Fantastic's real wife, and being the Invisible Woman. Well, it leaked last night that Krasinski did have a meeting with Marvel about Phase 5, but what position and role they're going to be playing was unclear. Now, his wife has had many reservations about getting in bed with Marvel, because of how the contracts are written, how long you're going to be stuck dealing with them, and in some cases, the money. But it is still unclear what role they will play in Marvel Phase 5, because we know they're trying to do the Young Avengers in Phase 5. We also know that Krasinski and his wife write and direct. So did Marvel bring them on to be writers? And the thing I showed you right before we started talking about the Marvel news was basically him poking fun about how close he's going to become to being a comic book hero. He's poking fun because fans across the Marvel spectrum have for a long time been lobbying for him and his wife to come in and be in the Fantastic Four and play that role, play those roles in the Fantastic Four. It would be funny as hell if he gets in here and they wind up casting his ass as Johnny Storm, and she winds up being someone else in the MCU, or if they're not the Fantastic Four at all. But Marvel has been very, very good about giving the fans what they want, especially when they see a lot of fanfare for something, because you know that's going to sell tickets. So even though it hasn't been announced what their role in Phase 5 is going to be, I'm just about certain that they will be the two parts of the Fantastic Four, and it's going to be a good thing. I think that we'll all enjoy their role playing the Fantastic Four. They are both great actors and actresses, and this could be really, really good for Marvel Phase 5 as we're going forward and learning what they're going to be doing in this role and their negotiations with Marvel. That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video. Comment about everything we talked about, from crooked landlords to toilet paper under COVID to what's going to happen with OT Genesis and this beef with Keisha Cole, all the way to our Marvel news of the day. And until that next sexy as hell video, I'll see you.